Hey everybody, Dutch Sense here. 4:57 a.m. Central Time on Sunday, February 12th, 2012. And this is a follow-up video. I just released a video called Utah Earthquake Swarm at Dormant Volcanic Chain, Craton Edge Pressure. Now, there were two subsequent earthquakes that occurred southwest of the area in Utah in California. Now, California is a really hard area to discern whether it's just regular earthquake movement or if it's actually associated with a man-made site, or if it's associated with a volcano, for instance. Now, you wouldn't think too many volcanoes down in this area, especially none that are active. So, let's go pull the coordinates here. Now, I've already done this. I want to show you guys what I found. Okay, and we're going to go open up Google Earth. Okay. Let this load. And I'm going to go ahead and paste in the coordinates, and we'll load that up, and we'll see exactly what's down here. Now, I had to poke around for a few seconds to find out exactly what was going on, and lo and behold, when I zoomed in, I saw just to the west a bunch of place marks here. First of all, you've got, to the west, you've got Springs, and you've got the Anza Borrego State Park, and I knew I had heard that somewhere before, and the reason I'd heard that is because of Table Mountain. Now here's Table Mountain, let me go ahead and zoom it in. Alright, and Table Mountain is actually a volcano. Alright, it's an old dormant volcano, and I had read about that a long time ago, and it just stuck in my head. Also, the Carrizo Mountain up here to the north is also a series of dormant volcanoes. And so if you go look that up, you'll find all kinds of stuff about this. And so the earthquake that's occurring here, this swarm, this 3.0 and 2.9, basically another 3.0, is indeed happening within just a few miles of a dormant volcano. And let me just get a measurement on this. To Table Mountain. All right, just 1 second here, guys. And let's go down here. It's 8 miles to Table Mountain. And let's get another measurement from... It's 7.5 miles to the north to the Carrizo Mountains. And I would even say that possibly this darker colored rock here, this series of old weathered hills, could also be a series of dormant volcanoes that are not marked. But, I mean, for sure marked, just down here to the south is Table Mountain. So when you put those two events together, that you're seeing a earthquake swarm of 3.0 occur up here to the north in Utah at a dormant volcano chain, and you're seeing multiple 3.0s occur to the southwest at the same kind of volcanic chain, well, I put those two events together and say that they're related. So, we'll have to watch, see if anything else occurs. It's why it's really important to go look up these earthquake epicenters and really, really study and see what the other people have posted, because this stuff isn't USGS posted. This is user posted. This is Google Earth posted. So, Google Earth takes these maps, they upload the peaks, and you just literally have to either know about Table Mountain, or you have to be able to zoom in and look at these pictures and see what other people are saying. So, cheers, folks. Much love.